So today I'll be talking about what is the corpus callosum. So what is the corpus callosum? Well, the corpus callosum is a part of the brain, and it's this green part over here, and it's a very big part. And the corpus callosum is sometimes called the callosal commissure. So before we talk about the anatomy and the functions of the corpus callosum, I want to talk about a review of the other stuff. So let's talk about the first thing. The neuron. So this is a neuron. And what is a neuron? Well, a neuron is a part, or you could think of it as the building blocks of the nerve. And the nerves are basically the pathways that connect the brain to the other parts of the body. And this allows the brain to communicate to the other parts of the body. So let's look at the anatomy of a neuron. So the first part is the cell body, and it's sometimes called the soma, and it's this part over here, and the green circle is the nucleus of the cell body. And what its job is for directing the pathway of the cell, of the neuron. So where it should go. So you could think of it like this. At the end of the neuron, there will be two parts, this part and say this part, this neuron. Now, say this neuron would go to one of the arms, and this neuron would go to one of the legs. If the signal is from the brain, says, let's go, I want the legs to move, so basically you want the leg to go, then the cell body will say, okay, we cannot go to the arms neuron, we have to go to the neuron that leads to the leg. Then we have the dendrites, which are these parts over here, these tree-like, these branch-like stuff. And then we have, lastly, the axon. And axon is these yellow stuff we call Schwann cells, and they're made up of myelin, so they make up the myelin sheath. And the axon is another word for the axon is nerve fiber. And a myelinated axon, an axon that's only myelinated, is called sometimes white matter. So the white matter of the brain is basically the myelinated axons, and the other part, the dendrites in the cell body, make up the gray matter of the brain. So the signals can get to the dendrites, and then they go to the cell body, and then they go to the axon. So now, all the nerve fibers will make up what you call the nerve tract. So a bunch of nerve fibers is a nerve tract, and the corpus callosum is a nerve tract because it's made up of a lot of nerve fibers, and it's also made up of myelinated axons, so it's called white matter. And now it's fun fact time. So the fun fact for now is, did you know that the corpus callosum is the Latin word for tough body? So this is the brain. And the brain has this big part over here, and it's called the cerebrum. And it's this wrinkled part over there. And it can be divided into two hemispheres. So it's divided by what we call the longitudinal fissure. And the two hemispheres are the left hemisphere and the right hemisphere. Now, this is not in our perspective, but rather the owner of the brain's perspective. So in his view, this part is the left one, this part over here is the left hemisphere, and this part is the right. So now I'll go more in detail later, but now let's talk about the lobes, or the parts of each of these hemispheres. So these lobes are in both of the hemispheres, and the first one is a frontal lobe, and its job is basically involved in problem solving, motor function, social interaction, etc. It's involved in a lot of stuff. Then there is a temporal lobe, which is involved in processing auditory information, memories, and emotions. Then you have the occipital lobe, which is important for processing vision. And lastly, the parietal lobe, which is important for processing somatosensory information. And somatosensory information is information that can be sensed by all the parts of the body. So one example would be pain. You can sense it with your legs or your eyes or your nose. But something that wouldn't be would be vision. You cannot sense it with your legs, but you can only sense it with your eyes. So that's the job of the parietal lobe. And around the brain is what we call the cerebral cortex. And it surrounds the brain. It's a very thin layer that surrounds the brain. And the cerebral cortex has different parts that depending on where it's surrounded. So the part that goes around the occipital lobe is important for processing visual information. And it is called the visual cortex. the part that goes over the next to the auditory lobe is called the auditory cortex, which is important for processing auditory information. So, if you look at the brain, then you will see that the corpus callosum is right in the middle. It's right over there, in the middle. And it's between the two hemispheres, so it's part of the longitudinal fissure. So now, let's talk about commissural fibers. So commissural fibers are basically nerve fibers or axons that connect the two hemispheres of the brain. And the corpus callosum is made up of commissural fibers because it connects the two hemispheres of the brain. So now let's talk about the function. So first let's brighten this place up. And the first function, and actually the only function, is how it allows signals to pass through the two hemispheres. So, if the two hemispheres are often taught to be involved in two different, totally different stuff, and they are involved, but they're not involved in each one completely independently. They work together. So, when you hear someone say that the left hemisphere does this and the right hemisphere does this, basically they're saying that the right hemisphere spends more effort on doing it than the left hemisphere. So how I like to think about the corpus callosum is, say these are the two hemispheres, and one of them is holding a signal that it wants to send to the other hemisphere, and the corpus callosum comes, takes the message, and gets it to the other one. So now it's fun fact time, and our fun fact is, did you know that the corpus callosum is made up of more than 200 million nerve fibers? So now let's talk about the anatomy of the corpus callosum. So this is the corpus callosum, this green part over here, and it's divided into four subregions. And the first one is the rostrum, which is this part over here. And the rostrum is, the rostrum means a bird's beak because it's kind of shaped like a bird's beak. And it connects the frontal cortex of both hemispheres. So it connects the frontal cortex of one hemisphere to the frontal cortex of the other hemisphere. Then we have the genu. And the genu is involved in connecting the frontal cortexes too. And it's over here. And it's named genu because genu means a knee. And it kind of looks like a knee. And then we have the body, sometimes called the trunk. And it's over here. And it's important for connecting the motor cortexes. And the motor cortexes are involved in motor function. Then we have the splenium, which is important for connecting the visual cortexes and the parietal lobes together. And that's this yellow part over here. So, what did we learn today? Well, we learned about the functions of the corpus callosum, the anatomy of the corpus callosum, and we reviewed the basic parts of the brain. Thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. And I have the thalamus video over here, and the pituitary gland video over here.